Hello mortals. Our sun is such a lovely star, providing us with light and heat and skin cancer sometimes. You and me would have never existed if not for it. Wouldn't it be a shame if we make some slight changes to our solar system and this happens? So let's take a look at what would happen if we replace our sun with some rather exotic objects from throughout the universe. Thanks to Magellan TV for sponsoring this episode. If the sun were to suddenly disappear from the center of the solar
Good song choice.
Solar system, we wouldn't know about it for 8 minutes and 20 seconds.
I'm always playing this one on my streams, so if you enjoy this song, you should come check out my streams.
That's how long it takes for its light to reach us. And what else travels at the speed of light?
Wait.
And what else travels at the speed of light? We wouldn't know about it for 8 minutes and 20 seconds. That's how long it takes for its light to reach us. And what else travels?
Yeah, we could talk about that endlessly, but we've already done that many times. The moon as well is about 1 and a bit seconds as well for light. So when you look up at the night sky at the moon, you're not seeing it as it is, but 1 second ago, as well as the sun, 8 minutes and 20 seconds ago.
At the speed of light. Gravity. That would mean that for roughly 8 minutes, all the planets would continue orbiting an empty center of the solar system before they all drift into outer space. Now that the sun is gone.
This is true.
Let's look for a replacement. How about we start with the closest star to the now-gone sun, Proxima Centauri. It is 6 times smaller than the sun and yet 1.5 times as bright. So even though the size difference, it would appear bigger in the sky.
Good night, Gavin. We're almost done. We're about to finish in like 10 minutes.
If we'd have a checklist of short-term effects, they'd include severe sunburns, or should I say, Proxima Centauri burns. And the planet's flying off into the darkness due to the weaker gravity. Now what if instead of one, we would have had 2 stars, a binary system? In actuality, more than 50% of the star systems contain at least 2 stars. For starters, that would make the orbits of the planets very complex if the chaos theory is anything to guide by. From a probability standpoint,
we'll be able to glean some of that, how true that is by with JWST. And looking at spying exoplanets and even the atmosphere, so that's exciting. Exciting times.
The nights would probably be very short, and depending on the type of the stars, the days would look different. The first half of the day could have a blue sky and the other half a red one, or purple if both stars shine on the same side of the planet simultaneously. Oh, and forget about the 4 seasons. We'd have like 20 flesh-melting summers and some chilly winters. So on the checklist we'd have, deadly sunburns, multicolored sky.
Well, it also depends on the planet and what it's doing as well. You can have tidally locked things like the moon, where, you know, one side is perpetually summer.
Pretty weird orbits, and a lot of vitamin C, maybe slightly too much of it. Milky Way, the pistol star. For starters, that means no more Earth, as its orbit would be engulfed by the outer layer of the star. Considering it's 10 million times as bright as the sun, you'd go blind even if you stood on Pluto. You'd probably also die. But the sky would look really brightly blue at least, so that's nice. But we can go even bigger. Let's replace the sun with the biggest known star in the universe, Stevenson 2/18. Now even looking from Pluto wouldn't save you. This monster would engulf the entire solar system. If you were to travel at the speed of light through the star from one side to another, it would take you 3 entire hours.
Oof.
Meanwhile, oof, for the sun, it would be 10 seconds.
It gets much bigger as well, but before we get onto the bigger stuff, you should come check out something I've created. It's a post-quantum VPN, and it can literally protect you from quantum computers, and that's going to be important going forward. So the beta is out. Come check it out, my friends. It's in the description.
And just in case this wasn't big enough for you, let's try a quasi star.
Quasi-star, however you want to pronounce it. But these things are theoretical. These things might not exist, my friends.
Giants probably used to live in the early universe. They grew.
When they say probably, that is not the case. Not many people are that convinced these things existed. They could have. One of the reasons why we think about these things is because we have to explain some way that galaxies got so big so quickly, black holes got so big so quickly. There's lots of mysteries surrounding the early universe and what the fuck happened, basically.
Grew so big that their core collapsed into a black hole and started slowly devouring it from the inside out. If the New Horizons space probe traveled for 20 years exiting the solar system, it would only then not be engulfed if a quasi star replaced the sun.
In the very early universe, you know, it was much smaller. The universe itself was just more dense, right? And so you had more gas and stuff coalescing because it was closer and, you know, collapsing into far bigger, you know, things. But no, you know, energy is created or destroyed in this universe, at least we think, unless, you know, ignoring particles popping in and out of existence. But, you know, the virtual particles, whether they exist or not, that's up for debate. The black holes, you know, the black hole information paradox, maybe they're actually deleting information. We don't know.
But size isn't the only parameter that can make a space object extreme. Take a look at neutron stars.
Hello, NB. You caught us right at the end.
Black hole wannabes that just didn't have what it takes. Neutron stars are usually small, no more than 20 kilometers in size. If one replaced the sun, it would be barely visible, and yet, it would doom the entire solar system, as all the objects would fall towards it and get instantly crushed under the insane gravity. If enough...
No, that's not true.
Enough matter falls into it, it could get past its critical point and make its parents proud. So on our checklist, we'd have the transformation of the Earth into
joke.
It could get past its critical point and make its parents proud.
So I don't think if we replaced the sun with a neutron star, if you replaced it with a neutron star that had the same mass as the sun, I actually, like, nothing's going to collapse. You could cause some instability. Things might keep going on doing what they're doing. If you get hit with its the pulses of the radiation spewing out at the poles, which is what they do, and when they flash Earth, we call them pulsars. I don't think much would happen. Because, yeah, they're so small, but they've got so much mass crammed in there. You don't have to do much to our solar system to make it sort of fly apart and things go wrong. There's studies recently showing that if a star come... what was it exactly? Even, I can't remember how close, but like even a little bit closer. All you have to do is... I can't remember the exact stat, but basically it would send Uranus potentially collapsing inwards or Mercury flying out.
So on our checklist, we'd have the transformation of the Earth into a neutronic omelet. But if that sounds...
into an omelet. I like how he's playing into the, you know, the nuclear plaster, pasta and things like that, which we think, you know, just these terms we give to the stuff potentially happening inside those stars.
We'd have the transformation of the Earth...
Is it nuclear pasta? It's not nuclear, it's something else pasta. I can't remember.
...into a neutronic omelet. But if that sounds boring, increase the neutron star's magnetic field 1,000 times over, and you get a magnetar.
Magnetar.
Would be 100 trillion times stronger than Earth's magnetic field. So
Earth's magnetic field isn't that strong, guys.
Add to the checklist the complete obliteration of Earth's magnetic field and pretty much any electronics on Earth. And if that's still not enough,
Maybe. You'd have to do the calculations to see how far, it would extend. It might not actually be all that bad. I guess if you got hit with the pulses, that would be bad in the solar system. But that goes the same for just a normal neutron star, probably. Because it's also spewing stuff out at those poles. But it really depends how planets orbit neutron stars, which I'm not aware.
Give the neutron star a good spin so that it rotates every millisecond. And
it's because today we just launched the we launched KelvinPN the beta, so come get it.
A pulsar, which emits radiation beams through its poles.
A pulsar is just a neutron star. Did he say that?
Neutron star a good spin so that it rotates every millisecond and you have a pulse.
They all rotate like that. Just FYI. They're all pulsars. It's just their pulse. They're not generally pointed in our direction.
Pulsar, which emits radiation beams through its poles. Considering the proximity from the Earth,
I wonder if I can do this song with this.
Such a beam were to intersect with us, it would fry the atmosphere and anything on the surface of the Earth with it in a couple of milliseconds. And if neutron stars were some...
You'd have to work this stuff out. I think he's just claiming this stuff. But, I mean, there's probably articles and things, papers people have written. So hopefully he's looked into this because I don't know this personally.
Somewhat extreme. Let's get to the champions of the universe. The black and white holes.
White holes... Completely theoretical, there's really no evidence for these things.
The story with black holes is fairly straightforward. Have one, the mass of the sun replace the sun and nothing happens except the slow freezing of the planet due to the lack of sunlight. However, humans might barely escape extinction by surviving off of alternative energy sources. But make the black hole the same size as the sun and the game over screen comes up much faster. You'll at least have a nice view in the sky during your last days. but replace the sun-sized black hole with the largest black hole in the universe, and your sky would look entirely black, and not only the sky but everything, because no photons would hit your eyes, because you'd be inside the black hole, probably dead.
I was waiting for this. Good jokes.
Most likely dead. Definitely dead. But that was to be expected. What's less than to happen if instead of a black hole, we'd have a white hole in the center of the solar system? As a quick reminder, white holes are the mathematical inverse of black holes. If nothing can exit the one, nothing can enter the other. We don't really know what they would look like since they are completely hypothetical, so we'll just go with the opposite of black. But a common misunderstanding is that a certain anti-gravity force pushes things away from the edge of the white hole. Instead, like any things with mass, white holes attract matter towards their singularity the same way black holes do. The only difference is that infalling matter would never reach the singularity. So if we had one replacing our sun, it would mirror the same outcome as having a black hole up until the event horizon. Once passed, assuming the Earth wouldn't get vaporized, it would start its eternal journey towards the singularity. Resulting from some fancy math that
I don't think this is actually correct. I don't know where they found this information, but I'm pretty sure this is incorrect. Anyway.
That neither you nor me can understand, after an infinite amount of time, a white hole would transform into a black hole. So at the end of our eternal journey, which will
spewing misinformation here now,
will never take place, we would still find ourselves at the heart of a black hole, which might be slightly disappointing. So in a way, we should be thankful to our sun. It gives us 6 more billion years to sort our shit and pack our luggage here on Earth to travel to some new homes before it engulfs Earth as a red supergiant. So make sure to embrace its sunlight. Just use sun cream, because apparently any amount of tanning at all is bad for your skin, so take care.
Yeah, can you tell Elon to hurry up and get us off this planet? So, just to take this guy's advice. But also, I just wanted to mention, so the white hole stuff, that is actually not, some people actually suspect the beginning of our universe could have been from like a white hole. And so he's actually quite incorrect there, I believe. But also keep in mind, like what he said about white holes as well. We don't know anything about them or whether or not they're real. It doesn't look like they are real. But anyway, they could be.